AC machines to 3-phase induction motor. The speed control of induction motor by cascading method. So till now we discussed the speed control of induction motor by injecting the EMF into the rotor circuit. Now we are going for motors by cascading method to control the speed of induction motor. So this also called as concentration or tandem operation of induction motors. This also called concentration or tandem operation of induction motors. So in this method, two motors are required, at least one of which must have a slip ring type called as main motor, while the second motor is called as auxiliary motor. Maybe either slip ring or squirrel cage motor. The speed control of induction motor by cascading method. The two motors are mechanically coupled as shown figure 1, so that both runs at the same speed. Here the stator of main motor 1 is connected to a 3-phase supply, while the auxiliary motor 2 is fed from the rotor circuit of the main motor. Here the stator of main motor 1 is connected to 3-phase supply, while the auxiliary motor is fed from the rotor circuit of main motor. So now this is called cascading of the motor. Here see, observe this one. Here this is the main motor. Why main motor? It is connected to 3-phase supply. This is 3-phase supply. Here the motor, this is connected, the supply is connected to the motor. Now so see here, these are the slip rings. Here this, from these springs here the motor 2 is connected. This is the auxiliary motor. So here slip rings and the wires, and this is the auxiliary motor. So if the torque produced by the both act in the same direction, cascading is called cumulative cascading. If the torque produced by the both act in the same direction, cascading is called cumulative cascading. If torques produced are in opposite direction, cascading is called as differential cascading. If torque produced are in opposite direction, cascading is called as differential cascading. Let us know P1 is number of poles of main motor. And P2 is number of poles of auxiliary motor. So now F is a supply frequency due to cascading of 4 different synchronous speeds are possible here. What are the synchronous speeds are possible here?
मेन मोटर्स इज कनेक्टेड टू सप्लाई इंडिपेंडेंटली, सो एन एस इज कॉल्ड 120 FP1. दिस इज द मेन मोटर स्पीड, सिंक्रोनस स्पीड, एंड द एक्सिलरी मोटर इज कनेक्टेड टू सप्लाई इंडिपेंडेंटली विद मेन मोटर डिसकनेक्टेड फ्रॉम द सप्लाई. एक्सिलरी मोटर इज कनेक्टेड टू सप्लाई independently with main motor disconnected from the supply, that is NS is equal to 120 FP2. So now in cascade, so combination cumulative produces effective number of poles P1 plus P2, therefore NS is equal to 120 FP1 plus P2. So in differential cascading, the effective number of poles are P1 minus P2. Therefore, NS is equal to 120 FP1 minus P2. Proof of cascade speed of the set 120 FP1 plus P2. Synchronous speed of the motor is minus one is NS is equal to 120 FP1. Let S1 and S2 be the slip of the motor 1 and 2. So now the supply frequency motor 2 is S1F, and therefore the synchronous speed of motor 2 is N2S is equal to 120 S1 by P2. Yes. So therefore synchronous speed of motor 2 is N2S is equal to 120 S1 by P2. The actual speed of motor 1 is, so here N1 is equal to N1 S1 minus S1, that is 120 FP1 into 1 minus S1, 1 minus S1. And the actual speed of motor is N2 is equal to N2S into 1 minus S2. So here N2S is 120 S1 by P2, that into 1 minus S2. As the two motors are here, as the two motors are mechanically coupled, the two speed must be same. If the two motors are mechanically coupled, the two speeds must be same, as the two motors are mechanically coupled, the two speeds must be same. Hence 120 F by P1 into 1 minus S1, that is equal to 120 S1 F by P2 is equal into 1 minus S2. Or here 120 F is cancelled. The finally remaining is 1 minus S1 by P1 is equal to, so 1 minus S1 by P1 is equal to S1 into 1 minus S2 by P2. That is 1 minus S1 by P1 is equal to S1 minus S1 by P2. But the term S1 S2 is very small and neglect. Hence, here, but the term S1 S2 is very small and neglect it. Hence, here 1 minus S1 by P1, that is S1 minus S1 S1 2 by P2. But the term S1 S2 is very small and neglected, hence 1 minus S1 by P1 is equal to S1 by P2. Here S1 P1 is equal to 1 minus S1 P2. So here S1 P1 is equal to P2 minus S1 P2. S1 is equal to P2 by P1 plus P2. The slip for motor 1 is P2 by P1 plus P2. And the speed of the set n is equal to 120 f by p1 into 1 minus s1. Now that is 120 f by p1 into 1 minus p2 by p1 plus p2. That is, therefore cascade speed at the set is 120 f by p1 plus p2. The actual speed will be less than this by the slip factor. In general, it can be concluded that the speed control of induction motors is much more difficult than the DC motor. So here, cascade method disadvantages.
Here the disadvantages of this cascade method is it requires two motors, which makes the set expensive. Smooth speed control is not possible, so operation is complicated, and here we discussed speed control of induction motor by injecting voltage in the rotor circuit. Thank you. And